each and every one of our ancestors were part of a tribe. Ladies and gentlemen, why are we so pessimistic about including them in our modern civilization? Good afternoon, respected judges, my fellow competitors and event heads. My name is Nyrika Guha, representing 3rd BCom C. Right, so I have 5 simple points to prove my assessment. First, there is a tribe called the North Sentinel tribe, ladies and gentlemen, which is located in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. What is so unique about the North Sentinel tribe was that until 2012, there was no human contact with this tribe, right? But then the United Nations organization came up with 2 devices. They took a neighboring tribe and made the tribesmen flee to the North Sentinel Islands. And now this tribe is trying to recover and coming into the modern world. This is their economic, social and political rights. Now, the second one is, in a study by the Harvard School of Business, it was proved that 45% of people living in the tribes are more smarter. So imagine these people coming into the society and serving for the Indian Army. It will increase the GDP by a large extent. Now, economic factors will also get much better if these tribes are included within the modern civilization, because the tribe areas are rich with natural resources, which helps us to increase export and import. So this is that social, political and economic rights which we aren't giving them. But the question is why, and the question is when.